From the depths of the ocean, from the depths of the sea, a truck's for you, and a truck's for me.
I want to look at this guy. I want to get a better look at this guy.
He bend. He unbend.
Hey, buddy.
You going to bend again?
Come on.
He changes his stance.
He's like avoiding talking to us. Hey, man, how's it going, dude?
What's up?
I'll catch you when I'm back in town, man. Right now, though, I'm taking this dynamite to Santa Cruz. Can you even believe it?
Haven't we at all, at one point or another, been tempted to take dynamite to Santa Cruz?
I know I have. All right, man.
Yeah.
It's the truck's time.
It's the truck's time.
I'm Isaac. That's Josh.
That's true.
What are we going to talk about?
Well, Josh, there's a bit of a paucity of interesting discourse to be had on the air right about now, and the
thing that's
on most people's minds is, you know, we don't usually talk about the thing that's the talk of the town right at the moment because we shy away from it. And this one's been picked pretty clean already by y'all opinion vultures out there in the tweetosphere.
The consensus of my tweetosphere is currently that this is now a blasé thing to talk about.
Yeah, this is a dead issue. It's already filtered down into the realms of the normies.
But you know what? It's been a while since we talked about a video game on trucks.
Yeah. And even though I haven't talked about this one, I would say that based on the admittedly scant research that I've done, playing this one is not the most interesting thing about it.
Oh, it's so boring.
So
we're talking about No Man's Sky.
We're talking about No Man's Sky. And just to bring you up to snuff, here is the... up to snuff? Here to bring you up to date, here to make you up to snuff is Isaac with a report about what's going on with No Man's Sky. So No Man's Sky was a game that was developed and sold for 60 human dollars, which makes it a AAA game.
It was a big... Sony pushed it hard.
Yeah, with a big marketing push behind it. And people bought it, and then they discovered that it was essentially a space trucking game.
No, not even.
Not even that. It failed even to be a space trucking game. It was mostly wander around the place, do some mining, maybe.
Yeah, like, okay, here's the thing. The defenders of this game compare it to a walking simulator, right? And I like walking simulators. It should be a game about, or they say the best things about this game are the bits where you're walking around on these lovely looking planets and just kind of enjoying the space, enjoying that feeling of scope and all that.
Scope.
It ain't good at that, though, because it all gets in the way. The game really tries hard to get in your dang way. Like, you constantly have to mine shit. And when you're doing that, you're not looking at the planet. You're just looking at this lump of metal that takes, like, a good 5 minutes sometimes to fully destroy. It's a failure in every respect.
Okay, it's neither fish nor fowl. It fails to be fish, it fails to be fowl. It was sold as something that wasn't fish or fowl, but was something entirely new, which it certainly isn't. Here's the news about No Man's Sky. The news is not that No Man's Sky is bad, because even people who, pretty much as far as I've seen, even people who are writing in defense of No Man's Sky at this point will admit that it's bad.
Sort of.
The issue is that...
not all. But that is not the point. Go on.
The issue right now is that there is a movement among people who bought No Man's Sky who want to try to get their money back.
Yeah.
And Steam, the nature of Steam at this point, means that you can do this, which we discussed a little bit when it happened because it seemed to us like a bad idea.
Mm.
So the tack that I've seen is like there are people who are, you know, putting their flag on this game as the latest bulwark in the culture war against, you know, the know-nothings.
Yes.
The Philistines, the gamers.
Yes.
And saying that these people are, you know, trying to tear this down because it doesn't do the thing that they wanted it to do. And, they're ideologically opposed to it because they're gamers. And,
right.
And then there's a hardcore of people who are trying to you know, organize people into getting their money back to try to put art back in the hole where it belongs, back in the $10 ghetto where it belongs, because art isn't allowed in the $60 place. So we should support this thing that is trying to be art. Mm. Is it?
Mm.
That is, I mean, that's hell of a thing to insinuate.
Shoot!
We should support this thing that is theoretically trying to be art, or at least we can agree is not fun the way that art is not fun.
just so we're not arguing against a straw man here, I will attempt to represent the argument as I have seen it.
Okay, that's exactly how I've seen it, I should say.
I'm sure someone has said that. I think the slightly more measured way that I've seen it put was that, you know, even if this thing is bad, you bought it, you played it, you know, you...
Yeah, you break it, you buy it.
You
bought it, you bid it.
You took advantage of the thing that was offered to you, you know? You made use of this thing, and to simply try to say, take it away from me, I no longer want it, and I want all of my money back, is perhaps an entitled position.
But what if you were sold a bill of goods? What if it was false advertising that caused you to buy the game?
Are we gonna go into all of that? Are we going to discuss whether Sean Murray is in fact a malicious liar?
Well, I think that it's an interesting question. It is considerably more interesting than the game. It might not be as interesting as some of the other questions around this, like what are you entitled to when you buy a piece of digital media?
Yeah.
Like, if I buy a thing, I can take the thing back.
Yeah.
If I buy a book, I can take the book back, usually,
mm-hmm.
because I cannot easily copy the book.
Sure.
Well, and in this instance, I cannot copy the game if it's on Steam. If I sell the game is gone. I no longer have the game if I return it. And so I have finagled myself the experience of having the thing for a brief time and then giving it back. But what I've essentially done by doing that is shortcut the thing where I get to play a friend's game or get to play a demo of the game if there was a demo, or, you know, get to watch YouTube video of somebody else playing the game and then decide that I don't want it.
Sure. Wasn't it nice when PC games all had demos?
Yeah. I thought some of them... You know, the thing about demos that I miss is that they demonstrate the real hole in the artistic landscape where short-form games should live.
Mm.
Like, we're talking here about, you know, this is a game that a lot of money was spent on this game. Is that
right.
Fair to say?
And yes, I would say so.
It was a big studio game, and it's
a small studio.
Yeah, okay.
But big publisher.
It's a big publisher. Small studio, big publisher. But anyway, a lot of money was spent on this game. And the question that I see is, well... Or that the question that I really haven't seen is, perhaps, what if, like, a moderate amount of money was spent on a really short game?
Yeah, you know, I mean...
It's like, surely there's a place for games that are like poems, right?
Yeah, that's how you get... it's rare to see that out of the AAA industry, but that is how you get PT, the playable teaser for Silent Hills. Remember that?
Yeah.
That thing was the bomb.
It was the dopity shiz, and like they immediately fired the guy who made it.
Yeah.
So they really weren't on board for hearing that lesson.
Yeah, it's a damn shame. Like somehow the one company that made that is Konami?
They didn't do it on purpose, that's for damn sure.
That's also how you got the first Portal, though, I will add.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, there's a thing about economy here, I feel, that if we're going to talk about why these games are not art, these AAA games are not, you know, are not being all, you know... good on a level that's more than entertaining. It's like they're trying to be enormous. I mean, that's the primary thing that brought this game down was its focus on an enormous universe with nothing to do in it, you know?
It's chasing a fantasy which we cannot yet achieve, you know, like
Spore.
One of the things just since we brought up the thing about Sean Murray being a liar, one of the claims of his that I find kind of the fishiest, I'm really not on board with like the Reddit thread with all the things that he said about the game that didn't come true, because that's game development.
Yeah,
you know?
That just happens.
But one thing that does kind of cause me to raise an eyebrow is when asked about why it is that planets don't have multiple biomes, you know, why it is that the planets are depressingly uniform,
right?
As you encircle their enormity. He says, "Well, we wanted every planet to have an identity, you know. We wanted this planet to be the desert planet, and this planet to be
like the blue Star Wars planet.
Yeah, sure, something like that.
It's a proven,
and that really strikes me as a dodge, because the actual answer is you can't have, like, a planet with the variety of Minecraft that you can view from space in, like, the same space as another planet. Your computer would crash.
Right.
you know, like...
Also, given what the game is, you would then never leave that planet.
Right.
There would be it would reveal that there is no reason for you to go.
Yeah, I mean, I think that the better version of No Man's Sky would be the scant amount of variety that the game has on a single planet-sized body.
Yeah.
But then you wouldn't be able to fly from planet to planet, and that's kind of the whole pitch of this game.
Yeah.
So this is what leads me to, we can't make this game yet. It can't be good yet. Unless you are satisfied with No Man's Sky, you know, good for you, but...
Right. So, like, here's my pitch.
Mm-hmm.
We are not punishing people for trying to do something cool by saying, this is a failure, and I would rather have not spent my money on this failure.
Yeah.
We are saying, this didn't work.
Yeah, it kind of did.
What other things might work? What lessons can we draw from the fact that this didn't work?
Well, and also, the big one.
And also, can I just say,
yes.
Like, how differently would I have felt about this if I had spent $10 on it and not $60?
Yeah, right.
What would my experience of this game have been had my expectations not been riled to the point that they were, and then my investment in it demanded to that degree?
And by your investment, of course, you mean my investment.
Yeah, because I knew better than to spend any money on this thing. It didn't look interesting to me. Jesus Christ.
Man, I knew it looked bad, but I was like, this is my genre, like, in a few ways. This is my discourse. But God, I really regret that decision. And you know what? I filed for the Steam refund after it came out that they were offering them after the usual cutoff, and I did not get it.
Oh, man. There you go. That's where the discourse should be. Where is our money?
Steam are so aloof, dude. Like, it is known that they have given out refunds for this game after the
cutoff.
So one of two things happened, right? Either I didn't, like, massage my message to the point where they were like, yeah, let's give the money back to this guy. Or
they were deluged with people trying to get their money back.
Yeah, that off. Or I, like, hit one customer service representative who individually is choosing not to honor those refund requests.
Out of principle. Because Steam is a black box, you know, and not regulated.
Yet. I really... I hate Steam a fuckload more than I hate fucking Hello Games. Another thing happened a while back where, like, my brother, back when, like, two internationals ago for the Dota 2 tournament,
yeah,
they were selling the compendium, as they do, the bonus thing that helps you follow the tournament. And the perk for that one was that if you bought this compendium, you got a desert terrain.
Mm-hmm.
And my brother had always been going on about how Dota ought to be set in a desert because all the music has those quote-unquote desert instruments. you know what I mean. Like, the music has an Arabic tinge to it.
I see.
Whatever, man. The point is, the desert terrain sounded good to him, so he bought that international compendium. But... What he never knew was that you had to activate the compendium in your inventory and that there was a cutoff date for doing so. And so what my brother now has is an unactivatable, untradeable, unmarketable compendium item in his inventory, a brick, essentially, which did not redeem any of his goodies. And when writing Valve about it, they said, sorry, we don't let you like, mark it. We don't let you do things to items that, you know, they send him the form letter.
Yeah.
So fuck Valve, dude. Like, this
they've definitely burned through any good. You know, they earned a lot of goodwill, but they have burned through it, man.
Yeah,
man, have they burned through it?
It's like they're refusing to honor a deal that they made with this dude a long time ago, which doesn't even involve, like, scarcity for them. You know?
Yeah. I feel like it's just a giant institutional inability to focus.
Yeah.
But just probably because they're chronically understaffed would be my guess.
But this is all off topic. But
it's and all completely opaque because, once again, it's a black box.
Yeah.
That's the problem with monopolies, kiddos.
This is all beside the point. The point is that No Man's Sky is evidence that video games are actually bad.
Oh.
No, it's not.
Really?
No.
I mean, that would have been a very interesting statement to make. But I think that if you put that in the subject heading of this YouTube video, we might accomplish for this video what No Man's Sky accomplished for itself. And best thing is we won't even have to offer refunds because nobody pays us to
do this. good news.
Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. So, like, paying for art, right?
Mm-hmm.
You obviously should pay for art because artists are human beings, too. And
they work hard.
Yeah, and they put a lot of effort into it. And the more time and effort they put into it is the less time and effort they can put into feeding themselves via normal means.
And art is already inherently risky because you're playing with the mercurial forces of whether or not the culture will vibe with what you're doing.
Yeah. And so, like, I think that if it happens to vibe with you, you should respect that. You should be like, oh, lightning has struck.
Sure.
Let me give this person my cash.
Right. I don't think the person who likes No Man's Sky is the person who needs us to tell them anything. Yeah, that person has obviously achieved a kind of video game Satori.
Well, that was my point, right?
Yeah.
Is like, can art... I mean, what the digital economy has done, essentially, is that it has... There have always been two kinds of people who give money to artists,
uh-huh.
you know, under sort of the art capitalism model that obtained when I was a kid.
Sure.
Which is, there are the people who give the money because they like the thing,
mm-hmm.
and the people who give money in the hopes that they will like the thing and then are disappointed.
Yeah.
Or even the people who give money because they want to dislike the thing.
Sure.
And want to have seen it in order to have disliked. But that's kind of liking the thing, right?
Yeah.
Whereas now we are moving closer and closer to a system where all compensation for art is elective.
Mm.
And I feel that people will continue to crack down around this and try to extend... the old economy into this, which is, you know, what Steam is doing by trying to put the Wild West into a box.
Mm.
But I think that for the sufficiently determined, you can just about get anything you want at this point.
Sure.
They keep shutting down, you know, Pirate Bay, and they keep shutting down Extra Torrent, and they keep shutting down everything. But
you
everything
can't fight it.
Just keeps coming on back.
Yeah.
And...
I mean, one solution to that, of course, is to deploy art in a form that can't be pirated. Live performances are a big one.
Yeah. But what you're selling there is an experience.
Sure.
And they have the experience. And you can't, like, preview an experience in that way.
Yeah.
I think that, you know, the question is, like...
There are a lot of questions.
Yeah, there are a lot of questions.
You and I walked out of a Keke King concert once, and we didn't demand our money back.
No, we didn't, but I could tell that, like, it wasn't the fall of Keke King that we were not enjoying ourselves. Okay, so let me amend
that. It was a terrible
show. It was really bad, but, like, I'll put it this way. There was a room full of human beings watching what she was doing with every outward expression of enjoyment.
Yeah.
Or at least not walking out of it the way we were. Possibly they all thought it sucked and were resigned to it. Maybe we were in a bit of a mood that night.
Maybe.
In another setting, we might have, you know, stuck around and see if it got good. Might have got good. Probably not.
If you hadn't suggested that we walk out, I would have probably stuck around and been vaguely bored.
Yeah.
You
know,
whatever.
That's sort of the deal. But it's like, point being that I wouldn't call, like, my salt on that particular occasion a referendum on whether she deserved to be paid for what she was doing there, because
Absolutely.
It was clearly, you know, something that had been put together and worked on.
Yeah. And so it sounds like we agree that Hello Games worked on this shitty game for 3 years, and it would be sad if they didn't get paid for it.
Yeah.
And so it's lucky that they got paid a fuckload for it. I mean,
yeah. This is good. I mean, well, that's the upside of the studio model is that if you can get paid for a lot of things without ever having to, you know, without having to appeal to a lot of people, which means that occasionally some really, really niche things somehow, you know, allow people to make their livings off of them by a series of what are essentially economic flukes and spillover from more popular acts.
Yeah.
And as that continues to fade, other modes have to be established, I suppose. I don't really care. I feel, I mean, my At the base of it, my attitude toward art is so vindictive that I, you know, my first instinct is to let people who make the stuff that I think is shitty starve. Possibly by force. But by putting them into gulags.
Do you want to talk about the uncomfortable halfway point games exist in between art and objects for use?
I mean, haven't we? I feel like we've discussed the shit out of that particular subject, but it's an important, you know, it's an important one. Like, the thing is that you and I have an avowed stance wherein we don't think that games are necessarily supposed to be fun.
Sure.
And I've gotten more grief on my blog about that than for anything else that I've ever said.
How come I haven't gotten any grief on my blog about that?
Because you don't blog.
I guess that's true. How come I don't get any grief about it on the YouTube channel? How come our YouTube comment section is your blog's ask box?
That's a really... I mean, you say that, but there have been people... Like, if you go back and look at the last Mumble Squad...
We get nice comments on the YouTube channel.
Oh, yeah. So what you're basically saying is, why aren't people more of a jerk in our comment space?
When people,
it's because it's a small community. They know we'll see it, and they know we'll respond to them.
The question is, how come when people are moved to argue with us, they do so exclusively with you?
Are you feeling left out, Josh?
Maybe a little.
Oh, Josh wants you to be... Josh wants you to argue with him. Go to Josh's Tumblr, which is jtrevitt.
You don't have to do that. Just leave a comment on this video. It's right there. It's down there.
Yeah. Josh, say some of your most controversial opinions.
All of my opinions are uncontroversial and highly correct.
Say some of your most...
I think that
unorthodox.
I
opinions.
Think that the best video games aren't fun. I love walking simulators. I think that art is a pretty low bar to aspire to. Man.
Yeah.
What are some others?
Art is a pretty low bar to aspire. I mean, that's not even controversial, man.
I disagree. People love to use art as like a marker of quality.
I know, but not. Nobody who's on our level, man. Nobody who's going to be watching this shit.
I guess you're right.
That's a scrub move. There are no scrubs watching this YouTube channel. All of you are like warriors.
Well, what about the people who argue with you on Tumblr? Are they also warriors and princes and princesses?
And warrior princesses. I hope there's at least one of those. Sorry, what?
Are the people who argue with you on Tumblr all of those things?
I mean, I imagine that it's mostly the same people, but somehow the medium of Tumblr brings out their inner...
I see.
Amphibians.
I see.
I don't know. I think the anonymous ask box is just has a way of curdling people into shit maggots, but I've also, like, barely gotten anything contentious through my inbox for a long, long time. It was a while ago, and it wasn't even through anything that we did on this YouTube video that I got those opinions. Yeah. It was through talking about... fucking Undertale, I think. Or Binding of Isaac or something.
Yo, this episode is ending way sooner than I thought it was gonna.
Well, I mean, it's you haven't gotten into any real jams driving-wise.
How can I like No Man's Sky? I mean, how can I dislike No Man's Sky when I like the game about driving trucks?
Because this game sets out to do exactly what it wants to do.
Yeah.
Whereas No Man's Sky... has ambitions which it cannot maintain.
Well, that was an easy question to answer.
Structurally unfit to produce the kind of Zen vibe that this does.
I tried hard to portray myself.
Also because the actual playing of this game, I hate to say this, is more fun.
It's
because
true.
It's harder and more interesting and more varied.
I did my best to portray myself as inconsistent and controversial, but I couldn't do it because I'm just too obviously correct all the time.
I mean, Josh, I'm sure that somewhere in there, that's what we should do while you struggle to park. You should both struggle. Oh no, it's the device! It's the device!
I think I've
you bested it. Excellent.
Oh shit!
Pride goeth. I said it was the device, but did you listen to
well,
me?
Well, the good news is we have plenty more time to talk about No Man's Sky.
I don't care about No Man's Sky at this point. I want you to say... I mean, because you all... Whenever we talk about stuff that's, like, politically sensitive or, you know, like, obviously maladroit in one way or another, you tend to either steer me away from it or we abandon those trucks completely. So what I want is for you to say something that you believe that might get you in trouble. Mm-hmm. Because you must have opinions that are not completely politically orthodox in your generation and community. There must be something in there that stands out.
I think it's...
Plus, you cannot escape from this line of questioning because you're stuck in the device.
I think it's boring when any art that takes a vaguely negative stance on anything that's happening in the world is read as a critique of capitalism.
Oh, okay. That's good. I'm really fucking impatient with Marxists right now, so we have that in common, maybe. Yeah. I remember that. What was the specific article?
There was one that came up inside. Like, inside was a critique of capitalism. And your retort to that was very good. It was that all the time capitalism is turning me into a hideous blob. Which I thought, you know, summed it up pretty well. Like, just because there's fascists in the game doesn't mean there's fascists, and there's haves and have-nots doesn't necessarily mean that the systems of capitalism are under critique. Mm-hmm. Just because capitalism can also be observed to cause those problems, you guys, it's impossible. Remove these from the game, dude.
Delete your blog. Delete your blog, manufacturer of the truck device.
It's unbelievable. Why would you build this in a place where trucks have to go?
I think specifically to madden and defeat you. You need to withdraw and plan your approach with more care.
I need to approach it from that road that's veering off to the right, but approaching that road is very hard because I'm currently locked in such a manner that my trailer is going to the left. If I do this, I will eventually run into this barrier, which is much more solid than it looks.
Your tire isn't even touching anything.
What if the video game is bad?
This one? The one that we're playing right now?
Yeah, what if?
I mean,
it's certainly... What's the button to unhook my trailer? Do you remember?
I don't.
Is it T?
Yep, you're decoupling.
Okay,
can you dig it, sucker?
Can I? What I would like to do now is... No, it can't be done. Unless I can drive over this thing. No, I sure can't.
I would say that American Truck Simulator is more visually beautiful than your Euro Truck Simulator, but it is not quite the same experience in a number of ways.
You know another subject of ours?
Partially because it's not big enough.
Another subject of ours that No Man's Sky kind of intersects with?
Oh yeah, do tell.
Is the point we made about Majora's Mask, that that's a game with recognition of what it actually looks like rather than what it would like to look like, what it's attempting to represent.
Oh, yeah.
No Man's Sky is oogly. And, like, it's one of those games where, like, I think I'm full-on stuck now. Let's just get it over with and get towed, huh?
All right.
Let's see if we can... Where I mean, whatever, we needed an extra village, few no minutes.
Man. Yeah.
It's a game where, like, the large creatures don't move any differently from the small creatures, you know? Like, their turning radius isn't influenced by their size. They just kind of spin in place.
Mm.
That's bad, man. That's shit. I'm being texted. It's okay.
By a boa constrictor. I'm being texted by
Jesus,
a boa constrictor.
There's raindrops. I remember the button. Alright, where the fuck are we? 27 minutes, 44, a very, very close distance, so I'm going to get a second shot at getting over the bump. Video games.
They towed us to a town that was literally 30 miles away.
Yes, all they had to do was tow us off.
Immersion is shattered.
I can't believe those.
This video game is terrible. This art is leaving me... limp, frankly.
Are we having an artistic experience?
I mean, I personally am having an artistic experience every time I sit down on this trucks with you and perform.
That's true.
Because I'm making art right now, out of myself.
If we were just playing trucks, would we be having an artistic experience?
Without recording it?
Yeah.
If we were
right
just...
now. I mean, I love trucks, and absolutely the answer is yes in general, but this particular situation...
This particular situation appears to be a... It's art only in as much as it simulates so much of what my life is like. It's true.
Yeah.
Like the new Vince Staples EP came out, right?
Mm.
And Vince Staples is a very, very depressed young man who is ideologically dedicated to the real He posits that music is good in as much as it is a accurate and authentic expression of what's going on in the maker of the music. And he has a certain advantage in this, mm-hmm. in that he himself is interesting and has led an interesting life. But what about people who are talented artists, or at least, you know, mechanically talented artists, who are not interesting people, Vince? Mm. What about us? Are we destined just to not be good artists because when we let out what is within us, it is of no particular consequence?
Hmm. These are the questions probed by uninteresting artists.
Yes.
Like Tao Lin.
Oh, Jesus.
This is like his wheelhouse, God. This question.
Are you telling me that I'm like Tao Lin?
I'm telling you that...
Did you know that Tao Lin makes salad by ripping little pieces of kale off in his mouth and spitting them into the bowl?
I think...
Did you know that?
I didn't know that. I think we're all a little bit more like Tao Lin than we'd care to admit.
Of course we are. Of course we are. We all make regrettable decisions and don't really know why we do.
Mm.
We're all slaves to our cycles and our patterns.
We're all inclined to pass off.
We're all stuck on an incline in a very literal sense.
We're all inclined to pass off our insincerity as something artistically moving.
Yeah. You know what? I think that maybe we should reach for sincerity here to... I mean, who are we to criticize No Man's Sky if we can't make a piece of art that is better in some way than No Man's Sky?
Are you sure we haven't made a piece of art that's better in some way than No Man's Sky?
You know, I think...
I haven't made a piece of technology as complicated as No Man's Sky, but that's different.
I think it's entirely possible that I have made better art than No Man's Sky. I suppose that's true.
I think it's completely accurate to say... that you have made better art than No Man's Sky. Have you read the writing in No Man's Sky, dog? it's so bad. What if I just go this way?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. What happens if you just go this way?
Maybe I get stuck on something else.
Let's find out.
It's another one of
It's another device! You better...
And that's no more favorable an angle.
No, it really
isn't. How would I ever, like, send... What you have to do is... What these things are is a checker to see if you can center yourself on them. And I believe it to be impossible.
This is an unwinnable math, man. This is
look at this. I'm turning as sharply as I can. I'm straightening out the truck, and if I keep going, I'm going to die. I don't see a way around it, do you?
I mean, no, I don't, but then again, I'm not wise in the ways of the trucko.
I need to, like, somehow straighten out here, but... The turning radius just isn't favorable. What might work is reversing down this other one.
There you go.
Let's give it a shot. Because I'm so good at fucking reversing a truck. No, the writing in No Man's Sky, dog, it's like... From square one, the first thing you read in this game is like... Your player character narrates his emotions to you when he encounters nondescript stone sculptures that say things to him. And it's like, I can feel infinity washing over me.
Can he feel infinity washing
over? Can you really? Is that really what the player is supposed to be experiencing right now?
What does infinity feel like, man?
Like, that's...
Does it wash? Is that the feeling of infinity?
I'm paraphrasing the game, so yeah, it would be unfair to focus specific.
I'm not picking on it. I'm just thinking, like, the amount of effort that it takes to make that an interesting thing to say.
Yeah, it is all that kind of thing. It's all like, I am blown away by the scope of everything. And
it certainly isn't the ancillary Destiny lore.
There's one... That's God, sure. Dude, some of that is so good. Like, but there's one where, like... there's one where...
I know, the joke is that you're right. And I know, for some reason... I know.
This is a disaster.
It really is, but please keep doing it. I'm enjoying this, Trucks. And we can't... And I've also decided that we can't get out of here until either you say something that's genuinely controversial, or one of us... says something that's genuinely authentic, or one of us in this Trucks video makes a piece of art that's better than No Man's Sky.
Like during
the Trucks video. And only then can we finish this Trucks.
Let me continue explaining No Man's Sky's writing in the meantime.
Please do. I'm gonna psych myself up to have like a moment of unvarnished personal intimacy with this microphone.
Okay. One of the ruins you can encounter, it says, like, your mind fills with the dreadful true history.
Holy mucker.
No,
No.
Unless I can kind of skate my way over.
Just. Can't you just?
I can't believe this.
No, please keep talking.
Your mind fills with the true history of the Gek, and the Gek have been these funny lizard people who like only ever ask you silly questions and then give you a blueprint. Uh-huh. And it's like, we are the Gek, look upon our works and weep. Like, literally, it quotes that poem.
Yeah.
And then when you click continue or whatever, you learn a random word from the Gek language. And that's it. That's the true history. That's the true dread history of the Gek. I can't believe...
Isn't that in and itself a joke? I mean, that seems like it's bad enough that it's a joke, right?
I don't think it's supposed to be a joke. There's nothing in the game to establish anything resembling a sense of humor. It's a really good game if you like post-rock, I guess, because it's got a tiresome-ass post-rock album playing in the back at all times. All I want to do is talk shit on No Man's Sky.
Speaking of bad writing.
Yeah. Dude, hey, speaking of good writing.
Oh, yeah?
I don't care if you've played Destiny or not. In fact, it's probably better if you haven't. Just Google the Books of Sorrow and read those.
They're really competent. I mean, that you would think you were reading a Homestuck fic by Urban Anchorite reading this.
They're like the most straight up loopy science fiction with like where the main character is the bad guy, and he ascends from like a shitty little alien insect knave to the dread king of death himself.
Yeah.
In the space of a short story.
Yeah,
and it's bogus. Like the way it actually manages to achieve a sense of scale,
and it genuinely does too.
Yeah, at one point they encounter the computer people, and like that it becomes a major thing in the plot that the Vex are just a thing now with all their logic problems, and oh my god, no, it's really good.
Yeah, the thing about gatekeeping,
yeah,
is that it creates artifacts like that.
Yeah,
somebody gets paid to write that for no discernible reason, and aren't we glad that it happened? And isn't that human mannequin that is us just ashamed of itself?
So I'm not hitting enter
can't
yet.
We see that in the void. Yeah,
I'm not hitting enter yet because neither of us has yet made a piece of art that's better than No Man's Sky, but I propose that the piece of art is the way I never turned off my windscreen wipers. And so during this whole ordeal, this guy has been perfectly still. What does it look like when he turns the wheel? He barely... Oh, he has a nice little animation for it. So how about this? Is this it?
Okay. So it's this it's this tableau. I'm going to complete it now.
Okay.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saves a wretch like me.
Bum, 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 bum. Is that it? You're going to go on?
I once was lost, and now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
But now I see.
We can't get out, because that would have been good if you had done nothing to undercut it. But you undercut it because you were self-conscious.
It was not an act of self-consciousness. What I did was funny.
That's always the excuse. I can't be fully present because it's too funny not to be.
Anyway, thank you for watching the Satisfactory Treks.
Yep.
I'll see you another time.
Bye.